Hello guys, welcome back to our YouTube channel. And in today's video, we are going to be unboxing and reviewing an important product that is necessary when you are setting up your solar system. And today's video, we are going to be unboxing and reviewing SmartEn Bravo Pure Sine Wave Inverter. This is a 3.2 kV inverter. So before we move on, I would like you to subscribe to our YouTube channel, like our videos, and if you have any questions, you can drop it in the comment section. And also, you can also drop it on our WhatsApp number. Our WhatsApp number will be displayed on the screen. You can message us to our WhatsApp number in case you have any issues. And in case you want to install your solar system, you can also message us to our WhatsApp number. And our WhatsApp number will be displayed on the screen. And also, it will also be in the comment section and the description section below. So, let's get started. Okay, let's start. What is an inverter? An inverter is an electric device that converts a direct current, which is a DC current, to an alternating current. So an inverter is going to convert your DC current from your battery to an alternating current, which will be used by your appliances like your televisions, your fridge, and all other appliances like your computers and any other appliances you are using in your homes. So we have a pure sine wave inverter and also a modified sine wave inverter. But this inverter we are going to be reviewing today is a pure sine wave inverter. Pure sine wave inverters are more expensive than a modified sine wave inverter. Why? Because a pure sine wave inverter is very ideally used for your personal computers and devices that are very sensitive, like your freezer. But a modified sine wave is less expensive, but it produces a low quality of electricity. But if you have the money to get a pure sine wave, I would advise you go for a pure sine wave inverter. Okay, let's talk about the features of this SmartEn pure sine wave inverter. Firstly, it has triple protection, which is the overload protection, the short circuit protections, and the wiring fault protection. And it also has an independent charger, which allows the inverter to charge your battery when it's been discharged. So the inverter can charge your battery. Maybe your battery has been deeply discharged, and then you have access to the main grid, which is the main electricity grid. Then you can use the main electricity grid being connected to the inverter to charge your battery. And also, it also has a changeover time of less than 10 milliseconds. So maybe there's just a cutoff in the main electricity grid, the inverter will automatically quickly change over back to the power from the battery in less than 10 milliseconds. So you can't even notice the change. Also, it is compatible with all types of battery, like the lead battery, tubular batteries, the AGM batteries, the gel batteries, and the flooded battery. Is compatible with all types of batteries. And also, it consumes less current when there's no load on it. So when there's no load on this inverter, maybe you didn't plug any appliances on it, it consumes less current from your battery.
Hey, before you continue watching this video, I want to quickly tell you about something. Have you heard about Opay before? Opay is a mobile banking app which allows you to transfer money to other banks and even Opay users, pay your bills like your electricity or cable bills, buy airtime or data to all network, and do some other transactions. When you create an account and join Opay, you get a welcome bonus of 1,200. But remember, for you to get the bonus, you must credit at least 2,000 naira from another bank. You get up to 6% cashback anytime you make a bill payment. There is free transaction and zero issues. You'll be able to get an instant and free debit card. All you need to do is for you to check the description section or the comment section for the link. Click the link and you'll be able to create your own Opay account.
Okay, let's talk about the features of this inverter. Let's start from the front of this inverter, which we have the button. We have the on button and the off button. And also, this button is also used to reset the inverter system in case of overload, in case of short circuit, and in case of high temperature and also low battery shutdown. So in case of all these issues, you can use this on button and off button to reset the inverter system. And also, we have here with the LCD displays that displays information about this inverter and also information about the battery that is connected to the inverter. Okay, so let's go to the back of this inverter and look at the features of the inverter also. Okay, let's take a look at the back of this inverter. This is the fan which allows to cool the inverter. It blows heat out of the inverter, allows the inverter, the transformer inside the inverter, and also the main board on the inverter to get cooled, because when the inverter is working, it generates heat, and then these fans makes the inverter cools the inverter so that it will not overheat. Also, here we have the positive cable which will be connected to the battery, and also the negative cable. So both this positive cable and the negative cable goes directly on your battery connections. So this cable transfers voltage and current from your battery into the inverter. Then also we have the main output here, the AC output here. Then we have, let me remove the case. Okay, so I've opened the AC output. So this is where we have your neutral, the earth, and the life. So you are going to connect your cable here. This is where the output sits, the AC output. So you are going to connect your neutral here, the earth, and the life connected here. And so this is a 3.2 kV inverter with a 24 volt battery connection. So make sure your battery connection is 24 volts. And the maximum capacity of this inverter is 3.2 kV. Okay, so we have the main MCB here, which is the main circuit breaker. So you can on and off the inverter, on and off the circuit breaker in case of emergency. And also, then we have a toggle button here, which allows you to select the battery AH, which is the amperes hour. So we have 100 to 135 AH. And also we have 150 to 200 AH. So if your battery AH is in between 100 amps AH to 135 AH amps hour, you can switch it to this place. And in case your battery is in between 150 AH to 200 AH, you switch to this. And sometimes your battery can be more than 200 AH. Maybe your battery is 230 AH. The batteries you are using for your connection is 230 AH, 220 AH, or 240 AH. You can still use the 150 to 200 AH for your battery selection on the inverter. Next, we have the battery type selection button. So you have the lead acid. It allows you to toggle between the lead acid selection and also the tubular selection here. So if you are using a AGM battery, a gel battery, or a flooded battery, you can switch it to a lead acid here. But if you are using a tubular battery, then you can then switch it to this selection here. Then also we have the WPS and the UPS selection here. The UPS selection produces, if you switch it to a UPS selection, it allows the inverter to produce a regulated voltage, and it's very useful for sensitive loads, while the WPS allows the inverter to produce an unregulated voltage, and it's mostly used for lightning loads and non-sensitive loads. The UPS mode produces a regulated voltage between 175 volts to 265 volts, which is suitable for your computers and your IT equipment. And the WPS mode produces an unregulated output voltage between 90 volts and 295 volts, which is suitable for all type of lights, fans, TVs, and lightning loads. Okay, so let's go to look at this toggling switches here. It toggles between the output and the main bypass. So if you switch it to the output, it allows you to output from the inverter, and you can also switch to the main bypass in case of maintenance. So the main bypass allows you to switch your inverter out of the circuit. It allows you to switch your inverter out of the circuit between the incoming main grid and the load. So in case of maintenance, you can switch it to main bypass to switch your inverter out of the circuit between the incoming main grid from your electricity and also the load. Okay, so we have the air vents at both sides of the inverter. which allows air to flow into the inverter to cool the transformer that is inside the inverter, and also the main board on the inverter. So with the help of the fan and also this air vent, they both work together to cool the transformer and also the main board to prevent overheating of the inverter. Okay, and so we have this mains cable here, where we have the red color cable, the black red color cable, black cable, and the yellow green cable, which will be connected to your power source in case you want to charge your inverter batteries, and also maybe you want to do mains bypass. So this cable will be connected to your power source, maybe using a 30 amps cable or a 15 amps cable, or connected direct to a junction box to charge your inverter, to charge your batteries, and also transfer electricity into your apartment. Okay, here are the accessories that comes with the inverter. Here we have the additional cable, which allows you to connect your batteries together, because this inverter is rated 24 volts. So this is the cable you can use to connect your 212 volt batteries together to get a 24 volt output, and has a cable lock so that you can be able to connect your batteries together. Also, we have here the DC fuse. It comes with some extra DC fuse, which you can use to replace your DC fuse on your board. So in case any DC fuse gets burnt on the inverter, you can use this to change it. And also, here is the manual that comes with the inverter. If you want closed caption on this video, you can click on the CC buttons to on closed caption on this video. I just released another video on Felicity charge controller, where I unboxed and reviewed the Felicity MPPT charge controller. The video will be added as an info card at the end of this video, and also the link will be added to the description section of this video. And also, you can also check our YouTube channel for other videos that are related to solar system installation, and also other videos we have on our YouTube channel. Thanks for watching. See you in our next video. Bye.